capacity because there's quite a lot that's taken place in the interim. So shortly we hope to be bringing back to members of the Environment Authority our updated long-term road strategy. Significant elements of that strategy picked up in this presentation, not least the £340 million investment that we've had in City Beach of Rail infrastructure. You'll be aware of the work that took place earlier this year for 6 months on the slab track on the Merseyrail Rail network under the river. We've got a series of projects that are ongoing, I'll touch on in a minute, and we've got the works that's about to start at the end of this month on Lion Street Station. So quite a lot of activity happening on the rail network in the city region. Lion Street Station, the investment programme there, there has been work taking place for a while, but on the 30th of September, we'll be closing Lion Street Station for 23 days to start the work on in earnest in the implementation of the introduction of two new platforms at Lion Street. There will be issues in relation to service provision into Lion Street, but Liverpool South Parkway, Highton and St Helens will be utilised as connections to provide a resilient transport network there. But what that will give us is a much improved Liverpool Lion Street station at the end of 2018 with an additional two platforms and significant concourse enhancement. Liverpool station received planning consent this week at Sefton Council. Completely new station between McGull and Town Green on the Ormskirk line and Merseyrail, another one of our growth deal schemes. Newton Willow station in St Helens, significant upgrade on station facilities with new lifts, ticket office, subway being installed, and a significant improvement to the parking facilities and the transport interchange facilities at Newton Willows. That's due to get practical completion in April of 2018. And the Holton Curve, one that we've been pushing for a number of years now in the city region. It's only a very short section of line, but it introduces very important connectivity between North Wales, Liverpool Airport and Liverpool City Centre. Again, work's now commenced on site and we're looking to see Holton Curve open to service at the end of 2018. Northern Powerhouse, the Metro Mayor touched on this earlier on, about the agenda stemming from George Osborne. We did receive commitment from the Chancellor last week that that commitment remains, and we're going to now push for that commitment to be delivered upon. That's something that the Metro Mayor of our city needs and the Metro Mayor of Greater Manchester are both aligned on, and that will be driven through that process. It is acknowledged the UK economy is unbalanced and we need to do something about that. The Northern Powerhouse is a key element within that, but better transport connectivity is critical to facilitate that counterbalance. Freight is a key component within that, so the freight sector and our rebalancing opportunity there. We touched on this before, 90% of the country's imports from India enter through Southeast ports, over 60% of them are consumed north of Birmingham. The opening of Liverpool 2 provides a massive opportunity to change that. It gives us the ability to take 150 million HGV miles a year off the UK road network, and it's a true opportunity to rebalance the economy from a freight perspective. Brexit, key issue here, with us having a westward facing port, we need to maximise on that opportunity, but again, critically, more rail capacity is essential to facilitate optimum benefit from the port. Liverpool 2 now open, significant investment, approaching £700 million in Liverpool 2. It is truly transformational. It takes the port from being able to handle 5% of the world's cargo fleet to being able to handle 95% of the world's cargo fleet. It will support the initiatives of 3MG in Widnes, it will support Parkside, it will support Knowsley Industrial Park, and a whole series of other logistics interchanges across our city. But again, that transport investment critical, because at the moment, it's taken 7 hours for a biomass train to travel 90 miles from the port to Drax Power Station. That can't be effective and efficient. High speed rail, we've had an aspiration for a long while now to get a better high speed rail offer for our city region. We've been told we won't get it through HS2, their budget's overcommitted, their programme's overcommitted, so we've been pushing through transport to the north as part of the Northern Powerhouse Rail or Crossrail for the North agenda, because we've demonstrated that a better link for us can get £15 billion worth of economic benefit for our city region and enable us to extract from the presentation that's part of that report, and what it shows is that the current proposals going to Liverpool now from Transport for the North are for a new line from Liverpool connecting onto the HS2 network via Warrington to then also connect through on HS2 to Manchester Airport onto Manchester and then utilise the Northern Powerhouse Rail to go further east. This intervention will give us what we're looking for in terms of our north-south HS2 connectivity, west-east Northern Powerhouse Rail connectivity, and create that freight capacity on existing networks. We need to drive for this now to become more than one word to become delivery for us as a region. It's not all just about transport infrastructure in the heavy sense, walls and our smart ticket platform for our city region. We are delivering now significant benefits from a smart card perspective. We've got 2.3 million Walrus cards sold to date and a total value of 18 million products put onto our Walrus card. Walrus ticket sales are now at £450,000 worth a week, and we are moving now Walrus into rail and looking to expand the portfolio of Walrus as a product. Merseyrail, can't talk about rail in our city meeting without Merseyrail. Merseyrail concession devolved from DfT to Mersey Travel in 2003. Merseyrail Electrics were awarded the concession in 2003. Joint venture 50-50 between Serco and Abellio, and is regularly now the top performing rail operator across the country on the National Transport Focus Service. Within that, the rolling stock programme is a key generational opportunity for us to modernise, obviously, a key element of our rail infrastructure, the rolling stock itself. So some background and an update on where we are with that. It's a cornerstone of the strategy that I touched on earlier on. Stadler were selected as preferred bidder, and the CA made the decision in December of 16 to approve the project and progress forward with Stadler. The rationale for driver controlled operation of the fleet was fully explained at that point in time, accepted through that process, and we're now in play with a £460 million programme, with an added potential of over £400 million in maintenance work to take place over the next 40 years. We awarded contracts in February of this year, and it's going to give us the facility to deliver a comprehensive modernisation of not just Merseyrail's infrastructure from a fleet perspective, but also the whole operational approach on the railway. Rolling stock itself, we adopted a best practice approach for passengers in consultation with Transport Focus. The procurement process is an unusual one in the UK at the minute. Mersey Travel are buying the trains on behalf of the combined authority. They'll be in public ownership. We've got a highly innovative and bespoke product there. They'll be safer, more powerful, and with greater carrying capacity, and they'll go faster. But it's not just about the trains. There's a significant programme of work on the depots. There'll be comprehensive modernisation of Birkenhead North. There's a completely new facility that's going to be constructed at Kirkdale. And Stadler programme appointed Van Nuttall, a Warrington-based contractor, as their turnkey contractor for those works. They've been encouraged very strongly to promote a local supply chain as part of that process, as part of our responsible procurement strategy. Mobilisation work's already started, the main construction due to commence in 17, and we're programmed to complete in 19 in advance of delivery of the fleet. The maintenance aspect of it, the business changes from Mersey Rail to Stadler in terms of maintenance on the 1st of October of this year. There are approximately 150 of the current Mersey Rail employees who will transfer to Stadler on the Jubilee, but the union consultation on that is successfully completed. Stadler will maintain the current fleet until it goes back to 2020 and then pick up management for the fleet from there on in. All the safety management systems for the new fleet maintenance have been established, and there's a review underway with the Office of Rail and Road, and the new fleet will deliver a step change for us in reliability, availability and presentation. Again, infrastructure is important. We've got to spend a significant sum of money on upgrading the power supply to enable the trains to operate. And we've got to do some significant work in platform training to the relevant safety bodies, the Office of Road and Rail, the Road Rail Safety and Standards Bureau, have both publicly confirmed that DCO is a safe method of operation on rail network. It's the only realistic way we can respond to the findings of the RAIB report from the James Creek fatality in 2011. It's worth understanding the RMT action is part of a national campaign as a consequence of issues on southern and northern and some other networks. You will be aware we've suffered 8 days of action to date. Some of that action has been targeted at high profile events like Grand National, the Open Golf and the Boat Show event. ASLEF aren't in dispute, but unfortunately the drivers aren't crossing RMT picket lines. But even on the dates that have been targeted, Merseyrail have been able to provide an effective skeleton service to get through those strike days. RMT are holding that national stance and one second safety critical person on board every train. There have been meetings looking to try and find solutions through this with Metro Mersey Travel, Liam. RMT have made suggestions about how they think that we could develop funding that would enable us to retain that second.